troublemakers making greater use of stop and search powers, and as such made more arrests over the 2 days than they did last year.
But that didn't prevent last night's clashes. Two London Tonight viewers had ringside seats to the trouble and made dramatic videos of events as they unfolded. Marcus Powell reports.
When the music stopped, the violence started. As the carnival drew to a close last night, groups of youths began to throw bottles into the crowd. Then they focused their attacks on the police. After a bank holiday carnival intended to welcome the world, the dark side of the capital emerged, with youths intent on violence launching missiles indiscriminately. Several officers sustained minor injuries and members of the public were hurt as they tried to flee the violence. Onlookers filmed the riot as it developed, but then had to duck for cover as they were targeted themselves.
So we're now trapped inside my flat on the rooftop, and we've had four or five bottles thrown at us which were smashed right up here on the roof. There's a few of us up here. We're sort of hiding and taking cover because we don't want to be targeted by these bottles, but downstairs the police have been driven back. There's a lot of gangs of people down there.
Safety was hard to find as the bottles hailed down. It was a while before the riot police were brought in and took assertive action to reclaim the streets and relieve the pressure on the unprotected uniformed officers who'd first come under attack. It was only this morning the police could count the cost.
Our officers sustained attacks from bricks, from bottles and from missiles. It is completely unacceptable behaviour. That wasn't a carnival, that was fighting with the police. And we had to move a lot of our police resources into that area and work really hard for 2 hours to disperse them and make the necessary arrests.
In all, there were 330 arrests over the carnival weekend and 9 officers suffered minor injuries. But serious assaults were down this year and there were no stabbings or shootings. However, today the police work began in earnest to view all the CCTV footage and then arrest many other rioters who escaped last night but will now be pursued.
It's from another world, the scenes that we wouldn't expect on a very normal street day to day suddenly to become just complete carnage and people running, screaming because they're very afraid that they're going to have glass hit them. And the police powerless, I thought, to stop for a couple of hours before the riot police came in.
Police stopped many troublemakers getting there. 150 youths were arrested in South London after tip-offs. They were all detained, preventing them from travelling. Amongst the weapons confiscated, 25 knives, a baseball bat and a taser gun. However, for most of the million-plus visitors to Carnival, it was purely for fun and celebration. Marcus Powell, London Tonight.
With London Tonight viewer pictures dominating that report. Now, Marcus mentioned that police stopped more than 150 youths reaching the carnival following tip-offs, and we have just received police pictures of that operation. Here they are. They centre on the road just outside the Oval cricket ground, and these incidents were yesterday afternoon. As you can see, the police sealed off the road and then processed the youths one by one.
Well, it is such a shame that every year the carnival is marred by violence. Do you live in Notting Hill? Do you get concerned for your safety? Is it time we changed the route so that it goes past fewer homes? Or perhaps have it starting and ending earlier? Will that make a difference? Well, the details that you need to get in touch are on the screen now.
Perhaps you think that we should just accept that this is the second largest street festival in the world.